Now, what I typically see with leaders is when they aren't great at prioritizing their time and when they are very reactive about going about their tasks and projects over the course of the day, the item that typically falls by the wayside is one-on-one coaching and development. And even when that one-on-one coaching and development happens, it's usually, again, reactive. It's because the leader hasn't made enough time for the direct report in the first place, so they end up using it as a catch-up session because they don't know when the heck they're going to be able to meet with their boss again. You know, you have to discern between your role in a one-on-one and a team member's role in a one-on-one. And a lot of times I've heard leaders say, well, I stopped doing one-on-ones because they weren't really going anywhere and people didn't have a lot to talk about. Well, whose fault is that? You know, if people aren't getting a lot out of one-on-ones, is the answer they're useless? Or is the answer we need to talk about the intention and purpose that if we are going to spend time together, boy, we better make that good. And what's missing? If they're not valuable, what's missing? So let's not stop doing one-on-ones. Let's revisit the approach we're taking to one-on-ones and the outcomes we're expecting on one-on-ones.